Good evening and welcome. Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance, led by Oregon National Guard Colonel Kevin Dial.
Please place your hands over your heart. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you.
Good evening and welcome. My name is Jay Weeks, principal of Roberts High School. I would like to welcome students, parents, staff, and the class of 2016 to tonight's celebration. You may be seated. We would also like to welcome special guests for this evening, Sandy Price, Director, Elementary Education, Salem-Keizer School District. Rick Kimball, Chairperson, Salem-Keizer School Board. Lorelei Gilmore, Administrator with the Salem-Keizer School District. Lisa McIntyre, Assistant Principal at Roberts High School. Beth Salisbury, Lead Teacher at the Structured Learning Center. Julie Saverio, Lead Teacher at the Literacy Center. Darren Hunter, Lead Teacher at Salem-Keizer Online. And Ron Paul, Lead Teacher, Downtown Learning Center. Students, welcome to your night. Tonight, we celebrate you and all that you've done and you've accomplished. Walt Disney once said, if you can dream it, you can do it. And you've accomplished a dream tonight. That list of grit, perseverance, determination, resolve, willpower, those are just some attributes that I think of when I think of you and what you've done to be here tonight. You entered the doors of high school full of dreams, full of hopes, full of aspirations, full of visions of success, visions of sitting here on a night like tonight, a high school graduate. That path that each one of you has walked is unique in your own way. Regardless of what path you've traveled, it has taken that grit, perseverance, determination, resolve, and willpower to make it. Never forget the memories you made walking halls, laughing with your friends, cramming for that one last test, or the goals that you've set for your future. Each one of you has a bright future, and while that future holds many unknowns, know this, you have what it takes to reach those goals because you have shown the attributes needed to be successful. You are all role models for what you've accomplished, and we are extremely proud of you. Dr. Seuss once said, you have brains in your head, you have feet in your shoes, you can steer yourself in any direction that you choose. At this time, we would like to honor you graduates with a video salute to the class of 2016.
By the it all on the line, we won't hesitate. We've come too far. So let the blaze keep going higher. It's in the flames that we shine brighter. Standing tall through it all, 'cause we are the fighters. And we say, hey, hey, when we go through the fire,
looking down at the background. That's not cause I put the whole heavens down, I follow the leader, and where he may take me may make me a leader. It's wrote on the wall, all you need to is read it. Can't be a late ducking, it's over the eagles. So I'm crossing the line, tell them all dogs that I lost too much time. Ain't staying in this place cause I gotta win a race and I'm running for a crown. Can't back it down,
I played it safe.
At this time, we'd like to invite our student speakers up to the stage. Our first speaker tonight is Adrian Montero.
Latino. Latino, Asian, African. What do all these races have in common? We all want to succeed in whatever we put our minds to. We're graduating. We have ended a chapter and we've started a new chapter in our lives. And we can decide what to write about in this chapter. Even if people label us, we always try to exceed in the task we have been given. From landscaping to white collar jobs like lawyers and judges, we are able to decide what we want for ourselves. Nobody can make us choose a path we don't want. As we become older, we have more responsibilities. That is what school has been for. A training ground, so to speak. It trained us to be accountable, responsible, and reliable. We have two paths we can take. One leads to great life and success, health, and a happy family. The other will lead to loneliness, self-destruction, and maybe jail or worse. But we as individuals have to choose the path by ourselves. Nobody can choose for us, not our parents, mentors, teachers, or friends. They can help us and guide us, but at the end of the day, it is our responsibility to choose. School was fairly easy for some and hard for others. We might have slacked off in school. I know I did. But by the end of my sophomore year, I put on my batteries and worked to achieve what I thought was impossible, graduating. But I had to work hard for it. Before my sophomore year, I chose friends over grades and school. I didn't pay attention and didn't turn in my work because I was too busy talking to my friends. At the end of my sophomore year, I saw how few credits I had. I panicked. I was five credits short of where I needed to be. I knew then that I had to change. My junior year, I decided to join an alternative program, online school. I started at Tiger Tualatin Online Academy and quickly got back on track. Then I moved here to Salem. I had the choice to go back to my socializing ways at a traditional high school, but I knew how successful I had been at TTOA, so I enrolled in SK Online. In Spanish, there is a popular saying, "Dime con quién andas y te diré quién eres." It means the people you are with influence your persona. I never really understand these sayings till recently, when I moved to Salem and changed my friends. So I decided I was going to change my ways of thinking and friends. From hanging out with people who would choose the wrong paths and always slacked off and constantly made bad decisions to becoming a little bit more introverted just to be able to focus more in school. I still keep in touch with my closest friends who have helped me out when times got rough and helped me get back on track. I also found new friends and made new bonds with people here. Those are real friends, not people who want you to fail or are with you because of money or different interests. Because of these decisions, I graduated before the end of the school year and have been able to take advantages of other opportunities that will help me in my future, like the NET internship, where I'm gaining work experience and skills that will help me continue to be successful in the future. The end of my sophomore year, I asked myself what my biggest challenge was. All of us need to ask ourselves this, and after we see it, we need to overcome it. during school, we had lots of friends and groups who could help. But maybe in the real world, we might not have any of this, so we will have to figure it out by ourselves. To do that, we need to be able to persevere whatever comes our way. We might fall and trip on our faces, but that doesn't matter. What matters is what measures we take to get back on our feet and continue our paths. Remember, we might fall 7 times, but we will rise to our feet 7 times.
Thank you, Adrian. At this time, I would like to welcome our next student speaker, Catherine Grisham.
Good evening, family, friends, faculty, and fellow graduates. My name is Catherine Grisham, and I would like to thank all of you for coming to celebrate the graduation of Robert's 2016 senior class. It's about time we're finally here. It's crazy to think that 4 years has passed in our high school career. It went by so fast, as if yesterday we were wandering the wide halls of a new school, rushing to find our classes on the first day. So intimidated and scared, but got better over time. From frightened freshmen to sophisticated seniors. It's been a long 4 years for me at Sprague High School. From freshman to junior year, I struggled with bad anxiety and depression, barely could pay attention, wanting to skip class, ignoring homework assignments, and getting horrible grades. Then senior year came by. It's supposed to be the best year of your high school career. Prom, your last chance for high school football games, senior banquet, your last high school assemblies. Being the top of your school. But that wasn't the case for me. Senior year was the worst year for me out of my high school life. I dealt with a very hard thing that many of us go through, and it was being bullied. I'm sure most of us here can agree by saying that they have went through that as well. Nasty rumors and people talking behind my back just added to all the stress I had already put on myself. That's when I finally had to make the choice of either staying at Sprague or switching to online school. One of the greatest choices I have made for myself was switching to online school 2 months ago. And here I am, speaking at my graduation. With so much more strength and confidence. With the help of teachers and staff at Roberts, I got to achieve my goal and graduate here today with the 2016 class. I don't know what I would do without the help of my two favorite cheerleaders, my mom and my dad. They have both been here for me through thick and thin. Every day I am thankful for what they have provided for me. Also, I don't know what I would do without the help of my sister, who is my other half, and my amazing supportive boyfriend with helping me have more motivation in life. I thank the U.S. Army for letting my dad be here today for my graduation. He is my biggest supporter. And he is the most strongest and courageous man I know. With his encouragement and support, I get to be here today graduating and feeling bright as ever. One of my favorite quotes I want to share is, "Believe in yourself and all that you are. Know that there is something inside of you that is greater than any obstacle," by Christian D. Larson. I strongly relate to this quote because out of all my obstacles I've been through, I powered through them. Don't get me wrong, even though I went through a lot, there has been some great things that come out of this year. I got my first job. I met a whole new group of people. I got to experience new things and make better memories than ever before. These past few months, I finally am starting to learn more about myself and break free from my shell that I've been covering up for years. I don't know what I would do without the help of my friends and family. Finally, I am starting to slowly find myself again and picking myself up one step at a time. We came into high school as children, and now we are leaving as adults. To our teachers and staff, thank you for sharing your time, knowledge, and talent with all of us. Thank you for listening to us and helping us keep on the right track for graduation. Without your help, some of us wouldn't be graduating today. To our parents, thank you for supporting all of us in many ways as possible. From this day forward, let all of us make each decision with our best interests in mind, and let us believe in ourselves and one another. Being here today just takes the first step. Now it's time to take the next step in each of our own paths and begin building our future. Congratulations, class of 2016. We made it!
Thank you, Catherine. I would like to welcome our final speaker for the evening, Andy Mariaka, to the stage.
I think my fellow speakers deserve another round of applause for such great speeches, right? Class of 2016, this day we shall never forget. I'd like to start off by saying who I am and telling you why I am here today. My name is Andy Mariaka. I have lived here in Salem all of my life. I started my education at Grant Community School, then Parish Middle School, where I spent most of my time in the band room. As a proud band geek, I stayed in band through my freshman year at North Salem High School. During my sophomore year, I herniated a disc in my lower back and had to end my education there, until I was given a chance to continue my education through SK Online. But I decided instead I would graduate with my friends. Like many people here today, Like many people here today, I have been through many troubles in life. Like so many of you in class of 2016, I am here only because of hard work and perseverance, and of course help from our wonderful teachers. But I must also tell you this truth. Even today, as we prove to ourselves and to the world that we have worked hard, many still see us as troubled kids. It's no secret that we as Robert students are seen as the bad kids. And I must admit, I once thought that too. But we're not here to talk about our troubles, rather our successes. The fact that we are all here, despite our individual difficulties, means that we've overcome, we've succeeded, and no one can take that from us. We collectively have proven that the sky is the limit, and that it's possible to change who people say you are. I suspect, like me, many of you have been labeled by the system. The system that's meant to help us. I've been called lazy, know-it-all, and much more. While I was lying in pain and misery, I had to read letters from the school threatening my parents with jail time if they didn't make me go to school. But I tell you this not to show you that our school system doesn't work, but to contrast the fact that there are good educators and bad educators. I can honestly say that getting taken out of school was the best thing that's ever happened to me. I was someone who thought that they could never learn math, that could never pass a single math test. Yet, because of the wonderful educators at the DTLC, who are more than just teachers, but mentors and friends, I, a hopeless case, am able to stand here proudly having finished my high school education. And I say hopeless case because I'm still someone who quite often counts with their fingers to do math. That's something that my 13-year-old sister makes fun of me about a lot. Some of us will be going into jobs, becoming adults. For you, I have this piece of advice. Don't allow this to be the highest point of your life. Though today is amazing, don't let tomorrow fall short. To those of you graduating with children, make your kids proud every day. Remember that you are living proof to them that failure is not an end point. It's a chance to succeed in another time, in a different way. Now, to those of you who will be going into technical school or job training, I want you to realize that you have something that most other applicants do not, and it doesn't appear on your resume, sadly. You have proof of determination and of courage with this diploma or GED. Show it proudly. Show that you have risen to the challenges of life and bested all that was thrown at you. Next, many of you will be going to Chemeketa. But I tell you, this is something to be proud of. You aren't just going to Chemeketa. You're going to Chemeketa. You're going to a great school where you will learn and grow in whatever you choose. Don't be ashamed of what you could obtain, even if people say that's not a great school. Let me tell you, people like that wouldn't know a great school if it bit them in the butt. However, I think that's partly because buildings rarely have teeth, if ever. But now I want to give some advice to people like me, who have been accepted to a four-year university. We've literally done what no one thought was possible. Personally, I never thought, even as a freshman, that I could get into such a great school for music as Northwest University, where I'll be attending next year. Yes, we do. But I want to tell my fellow future college students, never forget this experience, and always use what you've learned, as well as never just blend in or be another face. Stand out, you're different, and that's the most wonderful thing to ever be. Finally, to our parents, our families, our friends, thank you. You've stood by us, pushed us, and helped us. I know at least for me, I would not be here if it wasn't for my friends and family. So I want to leave you with this. When someone asks, what high school did you go to? Be proud of where. Let them know that you're not somebody who walked the traditional route, that you walked the hard path, and you didn't give up. We've earned the right to be here, and we've earned the right to say that anything is possible. Thank you.
The courage that it takes to stand before a crowd, the peers. Please, one more round of applause for our three student speakers. Now is that moment that you've all been waiting for, the presentation of the diplomas. School Board Chairman Rick Kimball and Director Sandy Price, I present to you for receipt of their graduation diplomas, the class of 2016.
Isaac Abercrombie. Isaac plans to pursue a medical career. Amber Natzel. Amber plans to go to college in the fall to study counseling or electrical engineering. Parker Jansen. Parker is going to the University of Nevada, Las Vegas, studying journalism. Wild Priest. Wild is going to work and go to college. Jordan Curry. Jordan is going to join the Army. Jamin Wright. Jamin is going to attend Chemeketa in the fall and be rich by 2018. Zyra Garcia Miranda. Zyra is going to attend Chemeketa in the fall. Idel Oliveira Jr. Idel is going to college and work because he doesn't get tired. Jacob Kirkpatrick. Jacob is going to start college in the fall.
Melissa McConville. Melissa plans to attend college and become a nurse. Araceli Gonzalez. Araceli plans on attending Chemeketa. Eric Ramos. Eric plans to become an EMT. Drew Groshi. Drew would like to be a bartender and eventually own a pet hotel that includes grooming.
Tyler Thomas. Tyler's plans include possibly college and finding a career. Jesse Twom. Jesse plans to be a mechanic and own his own shop. Connor Autry. Connor's planning on joining the military. Mason Shaw. Mason Shaw's planning on getting his new place and getting married. Anthony Cohn. Anthony is leaving for basic training September 19th for the Army. Greta Bryson. Greta is planning to become a missionary. Catherine Grisham. Catherine plans to go to the police academy. Adrian Montero. Adrian's immediate plans include traveling. Crystal Panteleon. Crystal plans to continue working and go to college for nursing. Samantha Corona. Samantha is planning to get experience in the medical field through caregiving and volunteering at the hospital. Alexa Miller. Alexa Miller is about to start working at Renew Consulting. Elena Lazukina. Elena will be working full-time to collect money for college. Jocelyn Keene. Jocelyn will be going to Chemeketa and then Humboldt University to become a shark biologist. Victoria Bennett. Victoria is going to attend Lane Community College for 2 years and then transfer to the U of O. Cesar Waterman. Cesar is planning to pursue his career in barbering. Alec Taylor. Alec is going to Chemeketa for business management and then for culinary to open his own cafe. Zenon Fierstein. Zenon plans to end world hunger.
That guy's gonna open a cafe.
Brooke Linke. Brooke also plans to go to community college in the fall.
It is fitting that our 100th completer, GD completer, happened this morning and is here with us today. We'll start with Bailey Linke. Bailey's going to college this fall. Austin Powers. Austin's moving to Oklahoma. Sarah McNabb. Sarah's going to college to earn her BSN, which is a bachelor's in nursing. Amelia Miller. Amelia's planning to go to college to study fashion design. Jessica Beck. Jessica's going to college this fall. Haley Scott. Haley's going to continue working and planning on going to college to become a nurse. Austin McPherson. Austin's planning on going to ITT Tech. Andy Mariaka. Of course, he's going to go study music at Northwest University. Christian Bogner. Christian's going to attend Chemeketa for horticulture classes. Jacob Cornett. Jacob's planning on going to college to study accounting. Kayla Weaver. Kayla just wants to get a job right now. Graham Smith. Graham would also like to get some work and also save his money. Isela Gallegos. Isela's planning on going to culinary arts school. Olivia Young. She plans on starting college in the fall in her quest to become an elementary school teacher. Timothy Exon Jr. He would like to get a full-time job that he loves. Gonzalo Juarez Asensio. he's going to start working. Becca Willis. She's going to continue to pursue her career as a belly dancer and take classes at Chemeketa. Natalie Adams. Natalie will be attending Chemeketa this fall and get on track to become a teacher. Isaac Neil Thing. Isaac will start Chemeketa next term. Nathaniel Tharp. Nathaniel will play rugby in college this year. Johnny Lambert. Johnny plans to open a no-kill pit bull rescue service. Sarah Marshall. Sarah plans on getting a job. Christian Jackson. Christian's going to join the National Guard. Ricardo Reyes Waldner. Ricardo's going to go ahead and plan on joining a men's rugby team to better himself. Erica Montez Olivas. She plans on starting college to study ultrasound in the fall. Adriana Hartzell. Adriana would like to go to college to study photography and to do what was going to be successful and that she can have a happy family life. Ruben Mendoza. Ruben will be going to college this fall. Jocelyn Montague. Jocelyn plans on buying 20 birds. Spencer Cartinez. Spencer plans on going to Chemeketa Community College for business and management classes. Aaron Louthan. He plans on joining the National Guard and going to Chemeketa. Seth Frank. Seth plans on going to college for engineering at Chemeketa. Haziel Ramirez. He plans on taking the welding program at Chemeketa. Nathan Seriano. He plans on becoming a wildlife firefighter and to make music. Brandon Sweeten. Brandon plans on getting a better job so he can become a better father to his child. Paul Garcia. Paul's looking for employment. Brendan Hegeman. Brandon's planning on going to college to pursue a law career. Kenna Marie McCall. She she plans on going into the medical field. Jennifer Alonzo. Jennifer plans on becoming a police officer. Natani Kinsley. Natani plans on getting a job to save up money to start college in the fall. Alyssa Linares Spinks. She plans on starting at Chemeketa Community College and after 2 years, transfer to Portland State University. Gabriela Guajardo. She plans on going to college and would love to pursue beauty school. Efren Lopez Juarez. Efren plans on going to college and to work full time. Ty Peterson. Ty would like to go to college to study nursing. And finally, Jackson Martin. Jackson's keeping his options open to explore new avenues.
Students, it is your hard work and your determination that has brought you to the point you are at today. We're proud of the perseverance and the resolve that you have shown to reach this point in your education career as high school graduates. Parents, we do ask that you please stay seated as students will leave the Elsinore during the recessional. Students will be leaving out the back and will meet you out front. You may greet them outside and celebrate and take pictures. Salem Police Department has shut down High Street right outside the Elsinore for you to celebrate with your family. Students, at this time, please stand and face the audience. Students, you may now take your tassel from the right side and move it to the left. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my distinct pleasure to give you the 2016 graduating class.